then today we are going to continue the lesson of chapter 2, Rise of Gandhi and Freedom Movement of India. In the last class we studied about Mahatma Gandhi, his biography. Today we will study here. First we will go one very important event of our Indian history, that is Rowland Act of 1919. So what is this Rowland Act? Let us look. So first we have to know what is Rowland Act. So Justice Sidney Rowland investigate revolutionary activities. That means at that time there was here and there in India revolutionary activities were there against British. So in order to investigate where are the revolutionary activities going on in India, Justice Sidney Rowland was given the responsibility of investigating that one. So when he was given responsibility, he was going to, and on the basis of these revolutionary activities, he passed the Rowland Act in 1919. What according to the Rowland Act? According to the Rowland Act, those who are found violating the rules and regulations, revolting against British or doing revolutionary activities against British, they will be imprisoned without trial. Trial means without any evidence, they can be put behind the bars. So that was the Rowland Act, which was a famous act passed during the time of British. So that was Rowland Act of 1919. Now let us look with the connection to Rowland Act, what happened. Next, Jallianwala Bagh massacre of April 13, 1919. This is one of the most tragic incidents which happened in India. After the Rowland Act was passed, many people of Punjab became AGF and they become furious against the British. So they started, they want to gather in a park. Park means one garden. And on that day, this Dr. Saitapal and Dr. Kichwal, they were taking the leadership of that meeting. When they were arrested, these people gathered in Jallianwala Bagh, a type of garden here, where it was enclosed all sides by high wall. All the sides were enclosed by high wall, and only one gate was there from where they can go. On that time only, General Dyer, without any reason, ordered to fire mercilessly to unarmed and defenseless people. So without unarmed and defenseless people, ordered to fire mercilessly. Then what happened? Lost 100 lives and many more were wounded. So this was the Jallianwala Bagh incident. And proclaimed as strong wave of discontent spread in the country. So strong wave of discontent spread in the country, and martial law was proclaimed after this tragic incident of Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Next, let us talk about Khilafat movement. Khilafat movement, what is this Khilafat movement? Influence of Khilafat reduced. Spiritual leader. He was considered a spiritual leader of Turkey and all the Muslims. And due to the defeat of Turkey in the World War First, what happened? Influence of Khilafat was reduced. Then, in connection with it, Muslim of India, what they had done, they had formed Khilafat Committee to restore Sultan of Turkey as Khilafat. So to restore him in the throne or to make him the powerful again, they found out one committee that was known as Khilafat Committee, and that committee was formed by Maulana Sukrat Ali and Muhammad Ali. So Gandhiji support this Khilafat movement to gain Hindu-Muslim unity. So that was Khilafat movement. Now let us look the second key point, that is non-cooperation movement of 1920 and 22. Let us look about non-cooperation movement. This non-cooperation movement was fought under Mahatma Gandhi's leadership in 1920, so 1920 to 22. So that was the year, and these are some of the causes which caused the non-cooperation movement. First was, if we look, discontent over World War First. World War First, heavy power, they promised our Indian that if we will support the war, then they will give us independence. But later on, they did not do that one. They cheated us. So that was first reason for non-cooperation movement. Second reason was Rowlatt Act. Already we discussed about Rowlatt Act of 1919. Third one is tragic incident. That one also we discussed about Jallianwala Bagh massacre 1919. Fourth one, economic exploitation by the British to the Indian people. That is the fourth cause for the non-cooperation movement. Fifth one is Khilafat movement. Khilafat movement also was the one of the reason for non-cooperation. These are some of the reason causes for the non-cooperation movement. Let us look about the activities of non-cooperation movement. What were the main activities? Bonfire of foreign clothes, picketing of foreign goods and liquor, left government school, no tax campaign. These are some of the activities taken during non-cooperation movement by the people of India. So now, what were the positive effects of non-cooperation movement? Promotion of Swadeshi, that means we have boycotted foreign goods and started accepting our own main goods in India. Hindu-Muslim unity started. Third one, production of prohibition of alcoholic drinks also started in India as a positive effect of non-cooperation movement. So negative effect of non-cooperation movement is triple boycott of legislature, court, educational institution, and surrender of title and honors. So these are some of the negative effect of non-cooperation movement. But which, although it is negative effect, but it necessitated some positive step also. Due to boycott of educational institution and court, what we call educational institution, national education institution was set up. So these are some, there are some positive steps which necessitated with the negative effect. Next, we will go to the end of non-cooperation movement. On 5th February 1922, one mob violence occurred in Chowdi Chowra, where local police attacked the protester. Because Gandhiji always believed in non-violence, and always he promoted Satyagraha and non-violence, but it doesn't happen. Some of the leader doesn't accept Gandhiji's system of non-violence, and they got involved in violence. Police attacked protester, in connection to this incident, Mahatma Gandhi was sent to jail for 6 years. And on February 12, 1922, non-cooperation movement came to an end. Thank you, students.